Tamale Senior High School, Tamasco, is the premier institution for secondary education of the northern sector of Ghana and was opened in 1951. The school was established specifically to provide opportunities for accelerated training of the youth to acquire knowledge, skills, and attitudes for rapid social, economic, and cultural development of the area. The idea, which has since been lingering, is for the North to catch up with the South educationally. The first curriculum of the school was, therefore, broad-based. It did not emphasize only academic pursuits, but also practical skills and character training. The curriculum included the following: English language, mathematics, general science, 1 and 2, geography, history, Latin, agriculture, carpentry, masonry, arts and craft, music and metal work. Dagbani and French were later added to the list of subjects. All students studied all subjects in the first 3 years and specialized in 8, which they studied in the 4th and 5th years and presented for the school certificate examinations.
We have a lot of qualified teachers in the school. I know the school does not recruit teachers who are not qualified to teach. The school always wants to take teachers who have teaching training background.
I teach English in Tamale Senior High School, and I've been teaching for the past 17 years. Tamale Secondary School is one of the best schools in the country, and perhaps the best in the 3 northern regions. It has all the facilities available for learning, and the atmosphere is very, very, very conducive. I can tell you that teaching and learning is so high.
The curriculum was actually designed for the rapid development of the area, principally by the people themselves. It is therefore not surprising that this curriculum, which was implemented in the school 60 years ago, is what has been considered as being appropriate for adoption as a program for the total development under the current education reform in the country. Very few secondary schools in Ghana started with such a broad vision, and it is worth noting that currently the school is one of the senior high schools in Ghana offering its students all the 7 programs available under the new education reform. It is significant to mention also that in line with the vision of the school for the holistic training of the students, the school cadet corps was established in 1954 and was the first in Africa south of the Sahara outside South Africa. The cadet corps was officially opened on the 11th February 1956 by the Honorable V.H. Alhassan, MP for Tamale, during President Dr. Nkrumah's regime. The commanding officer at that time was John Parson. In his honor, the school cadet training ground was now named Parson Square after his death. It thus preceded all other cadet corps established in Ghana. It had the singular honor of presenting a guard of honor to General Harding at the Tamale Old Airport as Chief of Defense Staff of the British Armed Forces when he paid a one-day visit to Tamale. The parade was commanded by Colonel retired A. Idisa, who was then the cadet sergeant. In 1958, the first batch of girls were admitted to Form 1, thus making the school a mixed school. In the same year, the first batch of special scholars was admitted to Form 4 through a special scheme which afforded teachers with high academic potential the opportunity to enroll in the school, write the O and A-level examinations, and continued to the university. In 1959, the sixth form course was introduced in the school, beginning with the arts program. From that period onwards, the school never looked back, excelling academically and dominating sister schools in sports and games.
Senior High. which is also known as the Northern Light. It is a very great school for anybody to attend. Why do I say it is a great school? Even the name, the Northern Light, it has carried out a lot of activities, a lot of teaching and learning for so many great people in this our society. We have a conducive environment. We have the laboratories, we have the classrooms, the dormitories, and very good students who are ready to receive form ones in a very nice way.
Tamale Senior High School, I would describe it as the biggest and best school in sub-Saharan Africa. Actually, I would like to use this opportunity to encourage every student who is not in the school yet to make efforts and get their way to the school.
The mission of the school is to recruit and maintain qualified, competent and devoted staff and admit BECE leavers who have attained the requisite qualification and ensure quality education delivery with a view to achieving academic excellence, high level of discipline, good morals, excellence in sports and games, as well as good sanitation. The vision of the school is to provide quality education to its students so that they can acquire the requisite qualification for further training in tertiary institutions and become responsible and productive citizens ready to assume leadership roles in the country's socio-economic development and poverty reduction agenda, as well as promote co-curricular activities needed for human resource development. In 2006, 53% of students qualified with at least 6 passes. In 2007, 77% of students who are in the science also qualified with at least 6 passes. In 2008, 77.8% offering arts also qualified with at least 6 passes. And 2009, 84%, mainly from the business program, also qualified with at least 6 passes. With reference to the comparative analysis of the 2006, 2007, 2008, and 2009, WASI results can be said, therefore, that there has been an improvement in the performances of the students. Foundation for Security and Human Development, an NGO, organized a debate competition among selected schools in Tamale, and Tamasco won the first position.
We are prepared to support those students who are ready to learn, to follow the rules and regulations of the school. And we are also prepared to support the headmaster and his administration and members of staff of the school to uplift this school to its deserved place.
We are preparing to celebrate our 60th anniversary, the climax of which will be on 17th December 2011. We are therefore calling on all stakeholders, the Assembly, the central government, all students, the PTA, to come to our aid by assisting us with facilities that we need to enable us to have a successful 60th anniversary celebration. We need to renovate our dormitories and classrooms. We need to provide facilities such as toilets and library books for our school library. We are therefore calling on all stakeholders and well-wishers of Tamasco, especially the old students of the school, to support us so that we'll have a successful anniversary celebration. His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, the Vice President of the Republic of Ghana, will be the special guest of honor. Alhaji Rahim Ogbedemosi, who happened to be the first SP of the school and a former headmaster of the school as well, and was the former Director General of GES, is the chairman for the occasion. Professor Joshua Labi, the Rector of IPS, is the guest speaker. There will be many dignitaries who will be present, and we are inviting everybody to come.
Tamasco is going to celebrate its 60th anniversary on the 17th of December. As 17th December gives Tamasco 60 years of education in the North. And Tamasco being the great school it is, we feel that this is the time students, masters, old students, and all well-wishers of Tamasco should come on board to assist the school so that this goal will be achieved.
Tamasco is the only school in the north that takes part in the National Science and Maths Quiz competition every year. In all, 17 schools participated in the competition. At the preliminary stage, Tamasco beat Wesley Girls High School. Wesley Girls Senior High School then met Prempeh College and won. At the 1/8 stage, Tamasco met Wesley Girls the second time and beat them again. Tamasco then proceeded to the 1/4 final stage and met St. Augustine's College. Unfortunately, Tamasco lost to St. Augustine's. The team ended at the 1/4 stage of the competition. This means that Tamasco have qualified automatically for the 2011 competition. The school won the regional competition and represented Northern Region at the zonal level in Kumasi. At the zonal level competition, the school won the second position and was given a 21-color TV as a prize for being the regional champion. The school management is guided by the GES Code of Discipline for Senior High Schools, technical institutions in dealing with disciplinary matters and the students concerned, get a hearing at the disciplinary committee sitting. Honorable Haruna Idrisu, Minister of Communications, supported the school to complete a new toilet facility by the science lab by donating 2,000 Ghana cedis when he attended the 18th speech and prize giving day ceremony. With the support of the school board, an appeal for funds was made for the rehabilitation of old buildings and purchase of furniture to enable the school admit SHS-1 students. Mr. Abdullahi Razak, an old student of the school based in Scotland, donated 25 home-used computers, 3 printers and 2 scanners to the school. Honorable Haruna Idrisu, Minister of Communication, assisted the school to benefit from the project. As a result of this, the school has received 25 new computers, 1 printer, 2 air conditioners and other accessories and internet facility. The school has only 1 toilet at the eastern side of the boys. With the completion of the lavatories in the girls' fence by the school PTA, there has been an improvement in the toilet facilities in the girls' dormitory. The school needs modern KVIPs or WCs, advantage points, so as to enhance good sanitation in the school. It is the desire to stock the school library with modern and relevant library books for the enhancement of quality education delivery. Stakeholders such as the school board, PTA, GES, Tamale Metro Assembly, old students, etc. should assist the school to rehabilitate the toilets and bathrooms in the school. A fence wall should be constructed to protect the school land, enhance supervision and maintenance of discipline. Stakeholders, especially Tamale Metro Assembly and OTA, should assist the school to construct at least 3 toilet facilities in the school.
This is a great school in the north, of course. Now, when we say the school in the north, we mean Tamasco. Tamasco has always been the northern light because of its position. And Tamasco has produced a lot of, you know, educationists, lawyers, doctors, accountants, you know, you name them, all over, not only in Ghana, but all over the world.
There may be one or two challenges, however, the major of which is that due to the vast nature of the school, it's virtually impossible to wall the school. And that makes the townsfolk rush in any time, and then the students also stray into town most of the time. But I know that the headmaster of the school is in contact with one or two agencies in an attempt to start putting a wall around the school.
There have been a number of activities lined up towards the celebration.